getting my head in here, man.
Hey guys, it's time for our monthly update on our Aliens power loader build. In this episode, we're going to be making the power loader's grippers, or as I like to call them, the jaws of life. As always, make sure you're following us on Instagram to see real-time updates on the build. The videos are released on YouTube once per month. Let's get started.
So I managed to do majority of the design while I was in class, and that includes the palm for the gripper, the hydraulics that are going to be moving it up and down, as well as the large hydraulic motor that's going to spin this gear and allow us to put different attachments onto the gripper. But now that I'm back at the shop, let's design the fingers.
All right, so as you can see, I just finished up mounting the hydraulics and the linear guide rail. And what that allows us to do is that when these hydraulics open and close, our gripper can move. So next, we have to figure out how we're going to manufacture these grippers, because right now, it's a solid block of steel, which would be very difficult and very heavy to manufacture. Instead, we're going to figure out how we can plasma cut this and then weld it together. So to actually do the perimeter plates, what we're going to do is we're going to select the face that's going to be joining all of them, which is going to be the side plate. And then we're just going to offset the entities, and that's going to take the whole perimeter of this, and we're going to set that 1/4 inch inside. And that will give us 1/4 inch to weld around when we get to joining these. So we can do that, and then we can select that whole chain and repeat the exact same thing so that we can get the thickness of our perimeter. Now we're going to separate the whole thing out into individual slots and join the piece. So now that we have that, we can extrude it out to the other piece. So let's make that visible, and we can go over here, select our perimeter plates, and extrude that out. There we go. So now we've got plates that cover the entire outside. However, while they do cover the whole piece, they would be very difficult to join because it would be very hard to hold them in the perfect place to make sure that the whole thing is parallel, straight and even, and there's no gaps anywhere. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna add tabs all the way around, like a jigsaw puzzle. And then what we could do is we could just slot them into each other, clamp it, and weld it all across. So let's get to it. So now that we have our whole perimeter covered in the tabs, what we can do is we can go into extruded cut, select our sketch, and select all our contours. So that's going to include the inside and the outside. And that's going to be the same for every one of these tabs. So what we're doing here is we're creating a gap of about 0.5 millimeter around each slot to allow us to have some clearance for the fit, because the plasma cutter, while it's very accurate, it's not perfect. It does have a little bit of slag, and there is a kerf on the actual cut. So to compensate for that, we are oversizing the holes just a little bit so that when we weld them, they'll still be able to fill in perfectly and we don't have to worry about trying to fit them in with like a hammer. They should just tab right in. All right, so now what we wanna do is we wanna get that exact same thing on the other side. We're gonna take all of those features and mirror them across. I am not supposed to be beatboxing. Whoops. Okay there. So now we just have to fix up the assembly. Alright, so now that's exported, let's go cut it.
This video has been sponsored by you guys! Huge thank you to all of our Patreon supporters over the years and our new YouTube members. When you support the channel on Patreon or by becoming a YouTube member, you get to see our videos early and help choose what projects we work on. And we post our CAD files for most projects. But the power loader project, as you can imagine, is not a cheap project. So to try and help fund the build, I've designed a new t-shirt that I think you guys are really, really going to like. It's a fun twist on the classic Darwin evolution diagram, except instead of becoming a modern Homo sapien, They graduate engineering college, design and build an Elysium-style exoskeleton, and then build a P5000 power loader. Oh, and did you guys know I formed Hacksmith Industries as a company back in 2013? This is a limited edition shirt sale on Bonfire, so grab yours before they're gone for good. Plus, if you're a Patreon or YouTube member, you can grab a coupon code to save $5 off the price from our regular merch store. Help show your support for the channel by buying an awesome shirt. Links are in the description below.
Cart is set, machine is homed. Are we ready?
Hit the button.
Is it done?
It's done.
Yeah, that's a lot of pieces.
Yeah, well, now we gotta deburr the whole thing, grind it all off, and then we can start welding.
We're gonna have fun.
All right, let's start putting together the first finger. We got all the side plates in, now we gotta get this top plate on. Now the whole thing is clamped, and we're gonna tack weld it around the perimeter to hold the whole thing together, and once we test fit it with the rest of the arm, we'll be able to weld all across and make it nice and strong. So now that it's all tacked up, we're gonna wait for it to cool, pull off all the clamps, and start the other finger.
So, got the fingers made. Now we just need the thing that holds them together.
The palm. Put together the palm.
All right, so we got it all held together with clamps now, which means we can tack weld it. Good to know we can crush a person completely.
Look at this thing. That's bearing.
And it goes right there.
Going right here.
What's it rated for?
Like 11,000 pounds.
You could put like a transport truck on this and spin it around like Lazy Susan. Or attach our gripper to it. Literally as big as the entire. Oh boy. Everything is moving. Oh god. It pulled me. Alright, let's put the other one in. Oh my god. We got a car jack, we got a log, and then we got Mjolnir holding up the arm so we can see if the bearing spins. So let's bring her down. Whoa. It's a nice bearing. Okay, don't try to do it. Loop-de-loop! Bogdan!
Got it! Well, it's down now.
Will it bind up when it's got like 20,000 pounds of force yanking on it? Seems to roll nicer. Yeah, might as well keep going. Alright, well, Bogdan's doing some of the finishing touches on the weldment. We can start looking at the hydraulics. This is something called a flow divider, and it ensures the same amount of hydraulic fluid going in one end comes out the other end. And that's really important when you have two hydraulic cylinders working in parallel. Because if you just connected them with a T like this, the flow would go to whichever cylinder has less load. So if we have this like this, we need that to go in the bottom and then over here. 2 feet isn't even long enough. Okay, so this is the arm. These are the grippers. Now we have to size all the hydraulic lines coming out of it. One line, and the other line. Now the confusing part. Let's just draw them on this side so we can... This one needs to go out of the way. So we'll need 4X. Now we just need to figure out what these hoses are. So from here to here. I'm gonna buy 5 and 6 foot. Shopping list. All right, so we got our shopping list, me and Riley. We gotta print this out, buy some stuff, come back. Bogdan will have it mounted.
Wait, what do we even come here for? With a cart? Best. Hydraulic.
Looks smaller.
Perfect.
This is what we want.
A swivelly boy.
But we can take a T adapter, plug the top of the T, and whammo blammo, we got the same thing. But the size we need.
Check.
Shopping list completed. Woo!
Screwdriver.
It's really not.
Yeah, almost.
Cut in there.
It's time to attach the 2 foot hoses. That one. And that one.
Yeah, come on, Cap.
It's tight for sure, but maybe it could be a bit tighter. I don't know.
Yeah. Look at this mess of hoses. So, the buttons work. As long as we power it up, and assuming Bogdan didn't design this wrong,
we will have a working power loader.
I hope so.
All right, ready for the big test.
Okay, here we go.
Nothing is moving.
Oh! You didn't tighten one enough.
Okay.
Oh!
Something's happening.
One is closing. And now the other one is... Why are they backwards?
It's a lot?
Nah, just a little bit.
It's tight for sure, but maybe it could be a bit tighter, I don't know.
Power! Lifter! Oh. It's opening! Closing!
It's closing!
Yes. Okay, we did it. Okay, ready? You guys ready for this?
Yeah.
Super epic crushing!
Hydraulic press?
Yes. Oh. It looks like a duck.
What do we crush now?
One hand.
In the eyes.
Yes. Here we go.
Indiana Jones.
Here we go. Here we...
Oh boy. Oh!
That looks so disturbing in front of the phone. Oh. Oh. It looks... Oh! Yeah! Feel the power! Yeah! Yes! All right, so you might have noticed when we started crushing things, the fingers kind of went like this. And we'll show some B-roll of that. Or you can just even see like here. That's because there's a bit of slop in the system, but we need that slop because the way we've actually designed this linear guide to save cost is we have bearings that actually ride in a track. And what happens is the bearing actually engages on one side and the other side, allowing it to spin, vice versa when it switches. This is actually the same way a garage door. So as you can see, there's these bearings mounted for the garage door. And right now they're riding on the inside of the track.
but as you go up, they'll actually ride on the outside of the track. So to get rid of some of that slop, we can either try and reduce the width that these bearings have to move. Still need to leave enough so it can actually adjust, otherwise it's not even gonna slide. Or we could add a second guide rail right here. The reason we didn't just use nice big honking linear guide rails is because they're really expensive. A guide rail that would be rated for what we're trying to do in this space would probably be a few thousand dollars just for the chunk of steel, which is crazy, and we can't afford that. So we made this, or Bogdan made this, but now we need to make it better.
So as you may have noticed during our initial testing of the gripper, you saw a little bit of flex in the actual fingers. Now, we anticipated that, but there was a lot more than we were hoping for. What ended up happening is during the welding of the railing to the side plate, the actual rail warped a little bit, giving us a little more space in the middle, which causes that huge deflection that you see in the grippers. So what we've done to mitigate that is we've actually added tie rods on either end of the gripper. So theoretically, with this new design, the bearings move very, very little, and that means that the gripper will not have the same amount of flex. So what we'll actually end up doing in the second hand is leaving a bit of material in the middle. So instead of having one big slot, there'll be two smaller ones, and that will make sure that the steel cannot flex or warp in the middle.
Ash brown.
Good start.
Okay. That's it. Okay. It's pretty good. A lot straighter too, now that we've got the tensioner in the middle.
Yep.
We might even just include this at the end of the video.
All right, this is so awesome. In the next video, we'll be fine-tuning the gripper, get it all painted, and then do a serious destruction video where we show off just how powerful these grippers are. Make sure you're subscribed and hit that notification bell so you're notified as soon as our next video comes out.